In this short video, we're going to look at the anatomy of an abstract. Now, an abstract describes a scientific paper or a poster. It should describe the work that is in that poster or that scientific paper. And the abstract should have an introduction in it. It should describe the findings, and it should give conclusions to the work. Now, generally, we find that there are two types of abstract. There is the abstract with subheadings, where there are specific headings such as aims and hypothesis, methods, results, etc. And then there's also an abstract without subheadings. Now, if we look at an abstract without subheadings, even though this hasn't got any defined sections, if you look at the abstract, it still has defined material. It starts with an introduction. It then lays out the aims of the work and then goes on to describe the results and the methods that were used to produce the data, and finally it draws a conclusion. So it has a defined layout. Now, if we look at the second type of abstract, where they're using aims and hypotheses and method headings for the abstract, again, clearly we've got sections. We've got an aims and hypothesis section. We have a method section. We have a results section, and finally we have a conclusion and interpretation section. So as you can see, there's a very defined structure to the abstract. So in summary, when you're writing an abstract, it should describe the work, it should have an introduction, just a couple of sentences at the beginning, you should describe your findings, again a couple of sentences, you should give your conclusions to the work, again a couple of sentences or so. Abstracts can be written in two forms, one with subheadings, and another where there are no subheadings, but it's still got this defined structure of introduction, methods, results, and discussion and conclusions. And it's also very important that you make sure you're using the right style of abstract for the type of work you're doing. And this is normally laid out in the brief for the particular work, be it a submission to a journal or a submission of a poster to a conference. And that's it. That's the anatomy of an abstract. That's what you should include in your abstract for your papers and posters.